For what purpose does the gentleman from Oregon rise?
I have an amendment at the desk printed in the record.
The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 96, printed in the congressional record, offered by Mr. DeFazio of Oregon.
The gentleman's recognized for 5 minutes.
Colleagues, 1990, Congress passed a law that required that all federal agencies, including the Department of Defense, must have auditable financial statements every year. Since that time, the Department of Defense has spent $10 trillion, $10,000 billion, and yet no audit has been conducted. In fact, there are numerous problems with accounting at DOD, and their financial management has been rated as high risk by the Government Accountability Office. Unfortunately, the Pentagon, being incapable of being audited, sought an exemption from audits. So in 2005, Congress passed a ban on completing an audit. It was contained in Section 376 of the 2006 National Defense Authorization Act. But in 2009, Congress got tough and they said, well, look, we've exempted you from audits, but let's have a goal, not a mandate, a goal of you doing an audit by 2017. Yet last September, in a hearing, Pentagon officials stated that meeting a deadline of 2017 for ever having their first ever audit of their books, and they will spend $4 trillion between now and 2017 without an audit, they said they would need more money to be auditable. That's chutzpah. That's incredible. So what we're attempting to do here tonight is to say that we're going to suspend the exemption. The DOD, it's time for them to get their books in order. There is nothing more important for our men and women in uniform than to know that every dollar, every precious tax dollar is being spent properly to give them the tools they need to defend our nation. And the taxpayers of this country, concerned about our massive deficit and the concerns that are being expressed here in these deficit and debt talks downtown, the taxpayers need to know that we're not wasting money in the single largest annual account of the federal budget, which is not audited, the expenditures of the Pentagon. In fiscal year 2010, half of DOD's contract awards were not competed. That's half. $140 billion of them, there was no competition at all, and in $48 billion, there was one competitor. So we have a lot of work to do here. In 2000, the Pentagon Inspector General found that $7.6 trillion in accounting errors, of entries, $2.3 trillion, quote, were not supported by adequate audit trails or sufficient evidence to determine their validity. I mean, we don't know where that $2.3 trillion went. Come on, it's time to stop treating them with kid gloves. The Pentagon's a tough institution, the toughest Department of Defense in the world. And it's time for them to own up here and audit their books and trace every dollar. It's a new era. So I urge my colleagues to support this. By defunding this special exemption, then the Pentagon will be subject to audit over the next year, which could provide tremendous benefits to our men and women in uniform and certainly tremendous savings for the American taxpayers. With that, I yield back the balance of my time.